Tyler.
Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Praise the Lord. Happy Mother's Day to all. Just take a moment and give God a hallelujah praise for the mothers and the mother figures who stood in the gaps of mothers. Just give a hallelujah praise. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank you for all the mothers and aunties and godparents and sisters, brothers who stood in the gaps of mothers. Amen. At this time, I'd like to welcome each of you here this morning on behalf of our pastor, Selena Johnson. We welcome all our guests. We just pray that this worship service just touch you in some way, whether it be through the songs, the music, or the spoken word. Just give God a hallelujah praise. Amen. We will now have our opening prayer by Ms. Robin Owens.
Let us pray. Most gracious and heavenly Father, we give thanks for this day, Lord God. We invite you, Lord God, into our presence, for we need you like never before, Lord. We thirst for you, Lord God. Thank you for bringing us through one week and now carrying us into another. God, we thank you for this special day, which we call Mother's Day, Lord. Those, Lord God, who nurtured us, those, Lord God, who just gave of themselves, Lord God, selflessly. And so, God, we give thanks for their lives. Oh, God, we thank you for those mothers who have passed on, Lord God, who we remember on this day by honoring them, Lord God, by making sure that we recognize those women who are a part of our lives, who just continue to pick up the torch and nurture us and check on us and to make sure that we're all right. God, you're such an awesome God. And so as we enter into this service, Lord God, we thank you for technology, Lord God. We thank you that we're able to gather, Lord God, in our homes, Lord God, and give you all praise, honor, and glory. And then, God, we ask that you would be with those congregations, Lord, for those people who will be in person today in their congregations. And I pray for their safety and their protection, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that even in the midst, Lord God, of all that's going on, you're still God sitting high on your throne, looking down, Lord, to see what your children stand in need of. And so we welcome you into this place, Lord, this sacred place. Holy Spirit, have your own way. For we recognize that you're moving and working in each and every one of us. And so, God, we give you all praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. We will now have a song of meditation, He Reigns Forever, by Mount Zion UMC Choir. Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah. He reigns forever. And good morning, Pastor Selena here. Yes, I do have a crown on my head. I'm a daughter of the King. Hallelujah. And it is Mother's Day today. So I'm also the queen mom in my family. Hallelujah. So this is Second Sunday. And we get to celebrate those who have birthdays in May. Yay. So if you have a May birthday, if you were born in May, or you want to celebrate somebody, who was born in May, just unmute yourself and shout them out or shout yourself out. Who are our May birthdays?
My May baby, Zach.
Yes. The best month of May has come, and on Wednesday, May 12th, it will be my birthday, Brother Caleb.
Oh, okay. Caleb's birthday. Hallelujah. Well, happy birthday to you, Caleb.
My birthday was last week on the 3rd of May. I was 88 years old.
Whoa.
Piano keys.
88 years old. She said piano keys. Hallelujah. Happy birthday to you, Sister Barbara Chris Thompson. Who else is in May?
On May 19th, I will be thankful and blessed to have another birthday. May 19th, I will be a senior, and I am very grateful to have made it far to all of my amazing, amazing May sisters and brothers. I will be 65 years old.
All right. Wow. Okay. She's going to be 65 years young. Hallelujah. Happy birthday.
Okay, Rachel. Go ahead.
On May 13th, I'll be 13 years old.
A teenager. On May 17th, happy birthday to you.
Okay. On May 19th, Michael, my husband, would be May 19th is his birthday. He'd be 54. And May 20th is my birthday, and I'd be 54.
Oh, okay. Oh, you got a younger man there.
No, he's older than
he's
now.
Old. He's one day older.
Yes, yes.
Happy birthday to y'all, born one day apart. Wow. Anybody else? Amazing. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
It's also James Featherston's birthday.
James Featherston.
This month as well.
Happy birthday to him. He's usually on, but I don't see him this morning, but we'll give him shout outs and prayers up to him.
They're celebrating the big graduation.
Oh, yes. All right. This is for y'all. Oops. Gotta find my right screen here. Okay, here we go. For all the May birthdays, the amazing May birthdays.
I hear it's your birthday today, so I'm just going to sing you a little birthday song. And it goes something like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Have a very, very happy birthday.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, indeed.
Indeed. Are there any wedding anniversaries that we're celebrating in May? Anybody got married in the merry, merry month of May? All right. Hallelujah. Okay. So I also would like to give a tribute, shout out to the moms today. So if you are a mother, I want you to just drop in the chat and say, I'm a mom of this many. You can say one, two, or how many. Just drop in the chat and say how many. Who do we have as moms? I'm the only one. I've been blessed to mother two people on this earth. Anybody else, mothers? Two. Okay, Patrice. Happy Mother's Day. Any other?
I am Bernice McCann. And I have I'm the mother of two. I had four, but I have two living now. And Barbara's birthday was May the 7th, and she was 72 years old.
Oh, okay. You had a daughter who had a birthday on May the 7th, and you had four. Okay.
I had four children, but I have two living daughters now, Barbara and Renee.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, well, I guess I should say I've been blessed to mother. I had a third one who is not alive today. Okay. Vicky, two. All right.
And this is
Camaro.
This is Gail, the mother of two.
Gail, the mother of two. All right. Happy Mother's Day to you. Anybody else? Alice Walker gave a Mother's Day shout out. May you feel the gentle touch of God's blessing on your heart today and always. All right, who are our grandmothers out there? Any grandmothers? How many grandkids? I'm gonna challenge you. How many grandkids can you name? How many you got? I don't have any yet.
This is Bernice McCann. I have 15 grandchildren. No, 10 grandchildren. So 10 grandchildren and 15 great-grandchildren.
And 15 great-grands. Woohoo!
Yes.
Okay. I think
and one on the way.
And one on the way.
Number 16 on the way.
16 on the way. Oh, my goodness gracious. Wow.
Yep.
Okay. We got one growing, and then one.
This is Gail. I have four grandchildren.
Four grands. Congratulations, Gail. Happy Mother's Day again.
This is Janet. I have three grandchildren. Deontay, Aaron, and Christian.
Okay. Happy Mother's Day to you as a grandmom. Happy Mother's Day. Any other grands, great grands, great great grands? I don't know. All right.
And Underwood has so many, I can't keep up with
them. She's got a lot. She's got a lot. Happy Mother's Day to her as well.
This is Dolores. I have one daughter and one grandson.
One daughter, one grandson. Happy Mother's Day to you.
I said something in the chat, but I don't know.
Oh, did it float by me? Okay, I hope I didn't miss anybody in the chat.
Well, I tried to do everyone, but I think it maybe just gone to somebody.
Just went to one person. Maybe. Valeria is a mother of two, grandmother of seven, and great-grand of three. And one on the way. Oh my goodness. Families are expanding on today. Hallelujah. Congratulations, Valeria. Shout out to Deborah Sadbury Haynes, mother of Monisha and AJ. Woohoo! Happy Mother's Day to her. All right, I'm gonna share this sound with you all. as you remember, moms have gone on and grandmoms and people have raised us. I just wanted to share this scripture with you all. It's from Hosea chapter 11. It just reminds us that we often refer to God as our Father, but God is our mother as well. And in Hosea chapter 11, verses 3 through 4, it says this. It was I who taught Ephraim to walk, taking them by the arm. But they did not realize it was I who healed them. I led them with cords of human kindness, ties of love. Them I was like one who lifts a little child to the cheek. And I bent down to heal them. God, we thank you for all the mothers and all the mothering. Yes, yes, Mama, I just want you to know. Loving you is like food to my soul. Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Amen. Amen.
Amen. We would now have our scripture reading, and it is coming from the Common English Bible. The scriptures are John, first chapter, verses 1-9. The story of the Word. In the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word was still with God in the beginning. Everything came into being through the Word. And without the Word, nothing came into being. What came into being through the Word was life. And the life was the light for all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness doesn't extinguish the light. A man named John was sent from God. He came as a witness to testify concerning the light, so that through him, everyone would believe in the light. He himself wasn't the light, but his mission was to testify concerning the light. The true light that shines on all people was coming into the world. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Amen. We will now have another song meditation from the choir. Say yes.
There is more than struggle. But we have to say yes, we have to let them into our hearts. We have to say yes. We want to go when you say go, Jesus. Because the safest place in the whole world.
Yes to God's will and that place of surrender to God. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much, choir, for that beautiful rendition.
Good morning, everyone. Some of you are old enough to know, like me, and remember back in the olden days in the 1970s, the legendary group Parliament Funkadelic had a song called Flashlight. Some of you old heads remember that song. And the refrain at the end, if you remember, they said, everybody has a little light under the sun, under the sun, under the sun. Right? Well, did you know that that is not an original thought right? John wrote that first, and he wrote it in our Bible verse for today, our focal verse for today in John chapter 1. I bet George Clinton didn't know he was breaking down some theological biblical texts when he wrote that song, right? Profound stuff in that riff. So I like to co-opt secular music, and I like to co-opt that song to say, everybody's got a little light under the S-O-N, sun. If we look at our focal verse for today, it's from John chapter 1, and verse 9 says, the true light that shines on all people. Somebody say, all people. Was coming into the world. The true light that shines on all people was coming into the world. The light of Christ is for all people, friends. And yet somehow, all people don't seem to be reflecting Christ. So today in our fourth in the series on living light, where we're talking about real ways to live out the light of Christ in our real lives, this installment is called Light Inspirations. Light Inspirations. Let us pray. Jesus, light of the world, light up this message, Lord, in a good way, in a positive way, so that people might hear from you and begin to reflect you in this world, Lord, and show who you are. I pray that I would reflect you as I bring this message. So remove me, God, from myself, and let the meditations on my heart, on all the hearts that hear this message, be acceptable to you, our strength, our Redeemer, our light. Amen. So there is, in this text, in John chapter 1, verse 9, there is a powerful Greek word that is used here for the word true in this text is the word alethanon, alethanon. And it means the true light. It means like real, genuine, through and through light. In other words, what it means, this is light in the truest sense. It's made out of light. Its integrity is light all through and through. So no matter which way you slice it, it comes up light. It's not just light on the exterior and then the interior is dark. It's not just light at the core and then there's rotten spots of darkness all around. No, this is true light. That's a perfect description of Jesus, right? And I think that's why John uses that adjective. Because Jesus said, I am the truth. I am the truth. And so we can trust him on that. We are called to reflect the light, like the moon reflects the sunlight, right? We are not that light, as John said, but we are the reflection of that light. And so just like a shiny object would reflect a bright light that's shining on it, that's how we should be. I met a very shiny Christian one time, and she shared her light testimony with me. I just want to share it with you real quick because it stuck with me. And that's how light testimonies are. When they're real, they stick in your soul, right? And she shared her light testimony with me. She was an evangelist. Let's call her Cecilia. I can't remember her actual name. But I met her about 10 years ago, and she was one of those spirit-filled Christians, right, who took that verse literally, that the praises of God should be continual in your mouth. So everything she said was praise God, you know, glory to God, everything she said. And so she was very spiritual. She was a very kind person because she would feed people out of her kitchen at her home. You know, people always knew they could go to Miss Cecilia's house to get food if they were hungry. But she was also a very, you know, put together kind of Christian lady. I mean, she had the bow on her head matching the bow on her shoe. Amen. And so she was telling me her light testimony, and it really stuck with me. She said she worked as an orderly in one of the local hospitals. And every day she would get herself coordinated with her colors and whatnot. But one day she woke up and the light inspired her. God's voice said to her, Cecilia, she was already dressed. She was ready to go out the door, head to toe coordinated, y'all. She was ready to go out the door, she told me. She said the voice of God spoke to her with a light inspiration. Put on the orange shoes. Well, she had a dilemma because the orange shoes didn't match. They were looking crazy with that outfit, but she put them on anyway. And all day long, as she worked in the hospital, she walked all around the hospital, up and down, all around. Nothing seemed to be happening. Then as she was leaving and going into the parking lot, she was tired from walking around all day. There was a man who was also leaving and being escorted, helped out to his ride. He was looking kind of feeble and weak. And he said, Miss, he called out to her, Miss, excuse me, Miss. She said, me? He said, yeah, you, excuse me. I want to thank you, Miss. Because today I came in for my treatments and I come here for my treatments and I don't like it. It's not fun. It gets me down. But today, every time I saw you walk by with those crazy orange shoes on, it made me laugh and smile. And so that's how the Holy Spirit works, y'all. That's how light inspirations work. They're just things that God puts on your heart to say, to do, and sometimes you don't even know why. But it's a light inspiration, if you will. So we should all be shiny, happy people like that orderly with the orange shoes on. But for some reason, we're not always, right? And some of us just aren't. So the question came to my mind, if Jesus lights up every soul that comes into the world, why then is not everybody not a shiny, happy person? Well, I'm going to tell you why. It's because of sin. Friends, sin is like the mud of life, if you will. It's where we get all muddled up in this life. It's where we miss the mark in this life. We all are flawed people, born in sin and shapen in iniquity. And so we don't get it right. We get muddied up in this life. And we're living in a fallen world. And so sometimes it feels like the muddiness of life is getting us down. Sometimes it feels like a fight, like a struggle with everybody against us in this fight in life. Sometimes it just can feel like a murky struggle and we get all muddied and mucked up. So, but I want to tell you my light inspiration for today. In spite of the madness, in spite of the murkiness, the light is still shining. We talked about this before. The light never ceases to shine. So don't let the darkness get you down, friends. Don't let the murkiness block the sun, S-O-N, and don't let it block your light. Jesus said in John 8:12, I am the light of the world. Whosoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. And so here's the last part of my light inspiration for today. It's not original. Y'all ready for the last part? It's not an original. Life gets muddy and murky. But here's the thing. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins. And sinners plunge beneath that flood, lose all their guilty stains. Lose all their guilty stains. Lose all their guilty stains. And sinners plunge beneath that flood. Lose all their guilty stains. Thank you. second verse is the dying thief rejoiced to see that fountain in his day. And there may I, though I'm vile as he, wash all my sins away. Wash all my sins away. And there may I, though vile as he, wash all my sins away. Since by faith I saw the stream, thy flowing wounds supply. Redeeming love has been my theme and shall be till I die. And shall be till I die, and shall be till I die. Redeeming love has been my theme and shall be. Amen, amen. Redeeming love shall be my theme and shall be till I die. If you are here today and you've not been plunged beneath that flood of the blood of Christ that cleanses, this is your moment. Don't let the dirt of life drag you down to hell. Don't let the doom and gloom of this fallen world drag you down to hell. Jesus is the rescuer. He gets you out of that situation. So if you want to pray right now, let's pray. Just say, Christ, redeem me, save me, forgive me. You know the wrongs that I've done. You know my heart. And I believe that you can save me by your blood. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen, hallelujah. Well, now is our time. I've been talking about light for 4 weeks now. So I wanted to open it up to a time of testimony. Do you have a light inspiration or a testimony concerning the light that you would like to share with us on today, briefly? Anybody have a testimony they want to share? Time of testimony, or drop in the chat. I hope you've been meditating on the word there in John chapter 1, verses 1 through 9. I know as I was meditating on this word, what struck me as I did the Lectio Divina, where you meditate on this word, you repeat it slowly, out loud. What came to me was that it kept saying this phrase came into being.
And it made me realize that I came into being because of the word. So Christ has dreamed up my life. I wasn't just born again in Christ when I was first born. I came into being. Nothing came into being without the word. Patrice said, I'm grateful that God continues grace and mercy to shine upon me during my trials and tribulations. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you for sharing that testimony. Anybody else want to testify on today? If you're on the phone, you have to unmute yourself with a star six.
Pastor Selena, this is Alice.
Hi, Alice.
Hi. I'd like to testify that many of you know my that Audrey Cooper had passed, and then you know I just had my aunt pass 2 weeks ago. Her funeral was Tuesday, and I was in a really dark place. And I reached out to Pastor Selena, and we talked and prayed. And she helped me restore my strength and faith in God. And I'm very grateful for her help to point me towards the light and the brightness that helped my heart. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Thank you for sharing your heart transparently and your light testimony. Amen. I was so glad to be able to pray with you. Caleb said, I'm grateful God has protected and covered us all through this raging pandemic. It has been quite, yes, we're so blessed to still be here. Those of us who are breathing today. All right, let's look to the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, you are light. You light up our lives. Help us to turn around and be light and salt in the world and to testify concerning the light wherever we go. In Christ's name we pray, amen. All right, it's time for our offering video. I'm gonna ask Patrice, our co-host, to go ahead and share that with us. God is doing in and through Mount Zion United Methodist Church. We are so excited to continue our weekly Meals for the Shelter Challenge, continue our online worship and our marvelous music ministry, our virtual history tour celebrating all that God has done these 205 years through the oldest African-American congregation in the nation's capital. And we're just so blessed. And so we ask you to prayerfully consider now your giving of your tithe or your offering on today. You can give online. Go to mtzionumcdc.org and click on the Giving tab. You scroll down, you can fill out the form to give through the website, or you can use Cash App. The cash tag is $ capital MTZION, capital UMC, capital G in Georgetown. You can also use PayPal through our online interface or by just using the church's email address. Or you can send a check directly to us Mount Zion UMC, 1334 29th Street, Northwest, DC, 20007. Amen. Just a couple of announcements before we go to benediction. Saturday Supper is coming up this coming Saturday. Mount Zion and Dumbarton are cooperating, but we still need some items. So if you're able to donate any Gatorade, any hot chocolate packets, or the fruit, the oranges and bananas that we give out, please let our outreach chair, Sylvia Onley, know. So that's this Saturday, the 15th. Also, our virtual tour has been postponed until anniversary, so it's going to be on October 17th. But the tour team is meeting on the 30th. And also on the 30th, we have a joint service with Dumbarton, so we'll be able to hear the new pastor there preach, Reverend Rachel Cornwell. Their service is at 11 a.m. on the 30th. We're going to their Zoom at 11 a.m., so mark your calendars. Also on the 18th, Reverend Marvin McMichael is going to be doing our Training Tuesday for our conference. You do not want to miss him. He did our annual conference one time and just gave us a powerful message about Jesus and justice and understanding in a biblical way. And he's coming to do that Training Tuesday. On the 22nd, some of our sister churches in DC, our sister UMCs are getting together and they're doing a mental health virtual summit to deal with the mental health crisis that we're all in because of this COVID-19. So check out the flyer that was sent out and register for that. And then as some of you know, on Thursday is Maria's homegoing service at 10 a.m. at the Glen Arden Bright Seat Ministry Center. Okay, let us pray. Merciful God, you've given us so much. You've given us this day. And we've been allowed to come and worship you. We've been allowed to testify, and we've been allowed to give back just a portion of what you have given us. So bless, oh God, the tithes and offerings, everybody who's giving electronically, who's sending their checks. Just bless them, oh God, and multiply those gifts as only you can, 30, 60, 100 fold for the building up of your kingdom here on earth. In Jesus' name, amen. And now, friends, if God has blessed you, if God has kept you, if God has made his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto yourself and be gracious and kind unto others as you go forth this week and do the same for someone else. Amen. Amen. All right. We're going to stop our